Secrets and scandal are woven into the history of one particular home in Allentown.
The man who lived there was living a lie. Tonight's History's Headlines has more.
We've had people walk up to us and introduce themselves to us and say, either I knew somebody that lived there, I played there as a child, or my parents lived there.
Barb and Bill Petro have learned that the home they bought 20 years ago at 16th and Walnut Streets in Allentown has seen a lot of foot traffic in its day. The home was built 100 years ago for Joseph Mack, the one Mack brother who wasn't in the truck business.
He eventually sold the place to Martin Kern.
And it's Martin Kern who may be the home's most infamous resident of all.
He really was really a fantastic con artist, actually.
Kern was in the insurance business. He moved to Allentown with his wife and mother in 1909. He became vice president of Mack Trucks after negotiating a loan for the cash-strapped brothers with investment banking house J.P. Morgan. In 1912, he opened a bank, the Penn County's Trust Company. Kern's star was rising, and high society in Allentown was taking notice.
The house was pretty lavish, and the reality of it was there were some pretty over-the-top parties going on here.
Kern's greatest business triumph came in 1918 when he purchased German company Bosch, maker of automobile ignition systems. But then he made a fatal error.
He had been seeing Marion Davies, the silent film movie star who was the lifelong companion of William Randolph Hearst.
After he got wind of the affair, a furious Hearst decided to dig up dirt on Kern. And he didn't have to dig too deep. Kern said he was Swiss by birth. He also spoke of a deceased brother, Edward, who had a criminal past. Both claims turned out to be bogus.
There was no evil twin. And so that was the beginning of the house of cards falling.
Edward and Martin were one and the same, a German con man who had done time at Sing Sing. The Bosch deal was off. Kern was ruined. He disappeared from Allentown and eventually committed suicide by cyanide poisoning in a hotel room in Newark, New Jersey in 1947. Now his fall from grace is fodder for lively discussion inside the very home he once called his own.
It's just kind of nice knowing that we're living in a chunk of history.